وين راح؟
هاي طالع
اجا
والله
نشرها
يلا بيتك.
Israeli settlers are emboldened like never before. After the October 7th Hamas attack that killed around 1,200 people, extremist settlers are increasingly using violence to seize land in the occupied West Bank. For months, BBC Eye has been investigating settlers waging a campaign of intimidation.
You don't have to touch me, man. You don't have
to
touch me.
Don't
I'm not touching
don't
you.
Don't touch me.
And harassment against Palestinians. We reveal how one is accused of shooting a Palestinian man.
إحنا عايشين في حالة رعب.
And how organizations with ties to the Israeli government fund and support settlers in this growing movement.
The idea is to clean the area from Palestinian presence.
זאת אומרת, יש כאן חשיבות לתפוס קרקעות, להתיישב, זה הקרקעות שלנו.
As Israel's war in Gaza continues, and more than 40,000 Palestinians killed, we'll show what's next for the settlers.
אנחנו חוזרים לעזה, נעיר את הסטי, נעזה!
מה שבדק תוך? תוך, אני בחב ללמוד.
Just days after the Hamas attack, here in the Israeli-occupied West Bank, a Palestinian family is being forced out of their home. The family say they are being threatened by a Jewish settler. Israeli peace activists try to offer some protection to the Palestinian family.
اعطيني ظرف الله يرضى عليك خليني احط لي كلتين بندوره فيه كنت ازرع في الارض هناك حوالي الدار يعني ما اشتريش نتفه اللحمه بس ولا كل الخضره كل اشي ازرعه حوالي وزن خالتي كانت جنة.
عائشة شتاية is now living with her husband Nabil at their son Muhammad's house, 10 kilometers from their home in the Hamra area.
أنا كل يوم بسمع ثلاثة أربعة تهديدات من أركان إسرائيلية ارحل ارحل الدنيا حرب ارحل هذا غير شرطة بيت يام
بجوز هم بعمل
معنا يا إنه هذا موسى هو بتخوث علي وبكل إنه أنا شرطة
هو مستوطن اسمه موشي بس إحنا من كل موسى طرنا من المنطقة
بده يسيطر على الأرض كلياتها بقول لك هاي لي
بقول أنا الحكومة وأنا القاضي وأنا الشرطة
يا عمي موسى اجى في خيمه بعدها جاب كونتينر بعدها جاب سياره عليها كونتينر بعدها جابوا له ست سبع اولاد يسرحوا له في الغنم بعدها في تهديد السلاح والشرطه بتفرجوا جيش الدفاع الاسرائيلي بيتفرج لمين نروح نشكي يا امرنا
احنا بدنا نرجع على بيتنا المكت والمرار اللي احنا فيه وحده فيه انا دي بنتفضن بحكي معك وانا على اعصابي
The person the Shtaya family accuse of leading the violence against them is this settler, Moshe Sharvit.
Abin! Abin!
He has become known in the area for his aggressive actions against Palestinians. Frequently captured in mobile phone footage filmed by Israeli peace activists. Since the war in Gaza began, locals say Moshe is responsible for forcing families, including the Shtayas, to leave the Hamra area. But Moshe paints a different picture of his presence here.
מפה בני ישראל בעצם נכנסו לארץ, אפשר לראות שהמקום הזה הוא מאוד רחב. אנחנו פה כדי לשמור על הקרקעות והאדמות שנשארו מופקרות עד שבאנו.
Moshe Sharvit is part of a movement to expand Israeli territory that began decades ago. In 1967, following a war with its Arab neighbors, Israel occupied the West Bank and Gaza. Not long after, Israelis began establishing settlements in the occupied Palestinian territories, claiming a historical and religious connection to the land. There are now around 140 urban settlements across the West Bank, where more than 500,000 Jewish settlers live amongst 3 million Palestinians. But Moshe Sharvit's farm, which he established in 2021, is different. It's what's known as a herding outpost. It gives settlers access to vast areas of land, which has led to violent confrontations with neighboring Palestinian communities. The UN says since October 7th, more than 230 Palestinians have been injured by settlers in the West Bank, and 17 settlers have been injured by Palestinians.
الأسابيع الثلاثة الماضية قام المستوطنون باستغلال انخفاض نسبة الاهتمام بالضفة الغربية من أجل تصعيد حملة الهجمات العنيفة.
I continue to be alarmed about extremist settlers attacking Palestinians in the West Bank.
نحذر من مواصلة اعتداءات قوات الاحتلال وإرهاب المستوطنين.
The town of Karawat Bani Hassan in the northern West Bank is home to more than 6,000 Palestinians. Ayub Rayan works for the local Palestinian Council. He monitors the expanding Israeli settlements and outposts that have come to encircle the town.
هون مستوطنة حفات يائير. منها وفوق مستوطنة ياكير. هاي المستوطنات هن موجودات من الثمانينات والتسعينيات وما صار بيننا وبينهم أي اعتداء. ولكن إحنا تقريباً من عامين، من عام 2022 بالذات، أتى مستوطن على هاي المنطقة وصار يحاول يفتعل أزمات مع المواطنين والرعاة الأغنام والفلاحين والناس اللي بيشتغلوا بعمروا في أراضيهم. هو بيكون معاه أغنام أحياناً، أحياناً بيكون لحاله. كنا استخدم أنا معلقه على وسطه. هاي الخيام الموجودة هي خيام موجود فيها الراعي.
هذا خيام الأسود يعني.
نعم. بنطلق منها. بيجي عن طريق التراكتورون أو بيجي بسيارة أو بيجي مشي.
In the last two years, settlers and Palestinians have blamed each other for the escalating violence here.
ערבים היו באים לפה באופן קבוע, זורקים צמיגים, מנסים להעביר את השטח, עושים לייזר על היישוב, צועקים, מקללים.
On December 2nd, 2023, there was an attack on Karawat Bani Hassan while the Israeli army was present.
(תקפה)
Ayub has come to the home of Mohammed Marai, shot during the incident.
كيف وضعك الصحي هسا انت؟
حاليا في عملية تجميل، في عمليات مساج، في عمليات ركع اللحم، بدها وقت.
كيف تصوبت؟
انا كنت اشتغل مع ابوي، قالوا اجوا المستوطنين فهجموا على الدور وصاروا يضربوا حجار وصاروا يحرقوا في الدور، وانا طالع لسه رايح على بيت اخوي صار المستوطن يطخ، فانصوبت انا هناك.
انو اللي اطلق عليك النار شفته؟
المستوطن
مش الجيش؟
لا، كان انا شفته اول ما طلعت بكى حد مستوطنين، كان هو قاعد مصوب، اول ما شافني طلعت ضربني. ويانا نطلع من المنطقه كل الدور، لو صح له يطلع من قراوه.
هذا هو؟
نعم.
كيف تعرفه؟
كان يجي في إنا لأنا عائلي عم إله غنم 300 راس، كنا نروح يخذهن يسركن.
يعني هذا المستوطن هو معروف إلك؟
معروف.
نعم.
The man Mohammed claims shot him is this settler, Eden Levy.
لو هي شتفيني تانو لمعركة لمعنى ارض إسرائيل.
Videos from 2021 show Eden present during campaigns to force Palestinians out of their homes in East Jerusalem. Later that year, he set up a herding outpost here, on the edge of a larger, established outpost called Havot Yair. It gives him direct access to Palestinian farms and orchards that surround Karawat Beni Hassan.
Hey, hey,
Most urban settlements have been approved by Israel's government and are legal under Israeli law. But outposts like Moshe Sharvitz and Eden Levy's don't have government approval and are therefore illegal under Israeli law. Many are subject to demolition orders, but these are rarely carried out. Israel doesn't publish official figures for the number of illegal outposts. But the BBC has analyzed data on outposts provided by settler watchdog organizations and the Palestinian Authority, verifying each location using satellite imagery, social media posts, and Israeli government publications. We found that there are currently at least 196 illegal outposts in the West Bank. All were built in the last 30 years, but almost half since 2019. The UN's top court has said all outposts and settlements in the West Bank are illegal under international law. Israel rejects this.
We're going now to an area which is east of Ramallah, northeast of Jerusalem. In the first weeks after October 7th, many Palestinians had been displaced.
Dror Etkis is an Israeli researcher and activist who has spent more than two decades tracking the construction of outposts and settlements across the West Bank.
It's an area which actually was one of the safest in the West Bank in terms of Palestinians' daily life. What happened is that in the last five, 6 years, a series of herding outposts had been established in this area. And they had changed completely the situation on the ground. It had become one of the most violent areas, and it has to do with the type of settlers which are establishing and living and expanding these herding outposts. Now, take a look to the right, you will see one of the Palestinian communities which had been displaced. Yeah. This is how a displaced community looks like. They left this area because they had been threatened by settlers, simply as that. Settlers supported by military, of course. I mean, it's never only settlers. It's never, ever. It's always settlers can do whatever they want because they're supported by military.
The Israel Defense Forces told the BBC they are providing protection to all the residents of the Judea and Samaria area, regardless of religion.
The idea is to displace communities in order to, terrible word, to clean the area from Palestinian presence. And you build new settlements and outposts in the same areas in order to make sure that these communities won't come back.
كيف حالك؟ إن شاء الله بخير.
إيه
أحسن إيدك أحسن؟
إيه ليها.
طيب حرك أصابعك أشوف. زور. We did an operation for him. We fixed the bone with blade and the screws, and we did repair the tendons that move the fingers. And the tendons were cut, and the bone is badly comminuted here. We fixed it. Anyway, he will be. He will use his hand, but not as normal. There will be some limitation. Fortunately, his nerves were intact. The wound is clean, dry. بدل تحرك أصابعك هذول عشان تمرنهم عشان ما يصيرش في التصاق هون.
دكتور بقول بدأ وقت شغل وقت بلاتين حطوا فيها. إن شاء الله بالمستقبل ما بتضر بس مأثر حالياً يعني أنا متضايق منها يعني معطلة في الحياة يعني في الشغل ما في الشغل دراسي ولا في إشي إيد طبعاً يعني واحد بيستخدمها في كل إشي مرة واحد ما بقدرش يستعملها نهائياً مشكلة يعني شو بدنا نسوي فين نضل
With the world's attention on Gaza and the humanitarian crisis there, violence has also erupted in the Israeli-occupied West Bank, some 50 miles away. Extremist Jewish settler attacks on Palestinians there have surged.
La France n'attendra pas plus longtemps. Elle a demandé aux autorités israéliennes d'y mettre un terme. Et elle prendra aussi des mesures nationales. Contre certains des colons extrémistes.
Nous מיישבים את ארצנו לאורכה ולרוחבה, שולטים בה, נלחמים בטרור תמיד, ומביאים בעזרת השם ביטחון לכל מדינת ישראל.
While ultra-nationalist settlers were once at the fringes of Israeli politics, today they hold key positions in Prime Minister Netanyahu's coalition government. Their political rise has been a boost to extremist settlers living in outposts.
הזכות שלי, של אשתי, של הילדים שלי, להסתובב בכבישי יהודה ושומרון, יותר חשוב מזכות התנועה של הערבים. סליחה, מוחמד, אבל זו המציאות, זו האמת. זכות החיים שלי קודמת לזכות
השר בן גביר.
Ultra-nationalist politicians aim to establish new outposts all over the West Bank and expand existing ones. Havot Yair is an outpost just across a valley from Mohammed's home in Karawat Bani Hassan. We heard about an event organized by local settlers. They described it as a hike, but they had a clear message to the Palestinians living opposite.
מה שחשוב זה הנוכחות פה כל הזמן. לטייל, להראות נוכחות, להרחיק אותם. אנחנו יישוב בלי גדר בכוונה, שהם לא ידעו לאן הם יכולים להגיע. שזה תמיד יהיה מאומם. אנחנו בהר שממול חוות יאיר, זה היישוב חוות יאיר. קיים משהו כמו 22 שנים, עוד מעט 23. אנחנו היינו המשפחה החמישית שהגיעה לפה. אנחנו נקראים היום ההתיישבות הצעירה. זה אומר שעדיין אין לנו אישורים חוקיים לבנייה. זה אומר שאם אני רוצה לבנות בית בחוות יאיר, אני לא יכולה להגיש בקשה לקבל משכנתה.
וואי, איזה קרניים ארוכות יש לך.
זה נראה יישוב פסטורלי ויפה ושטחים במחירים מוזלים, אבל אנחנו באמת כל דבר שקורה פה, אנשים יוצאים, מוצאים ממש מהכסף הפרטי שלהם.
איפה מתפללים? The youth are telling us where to go.
פה קשה לדמיין את זה, אבל לא היה פה כלום. וזה תמיד היה איזה חלום כזה, להרחיב את ההתיישבות ולגור. עכשיו אנחנו גם באמת רואים בזה חשיבות. זאת אומרת, יש כאן חשיבות לתפוס קרקעות, להתיישב, זה הקרקעות שלנו.
Havot Yair began as a small outpost with just a few families. Today, there are around 100 Israeli families living there. The hope for its residents is that eventually the Israeli government grants Havot Yair legal status, making it an official settlement.
במציאות שלנו הביטחונית היא מתחלקת בעצם ללפני המלחמה ואחרי, אני חושבת. הגשתי עוד פעם בקשה לרישיון נשק, אז אני ישנה בלילה, אני כבר ישנה בלילה, אבל אנחנו עם עיניים פקוחות. למה לאנשים יש תפיסה עלינו שאנחנו משוגעים ושאנחנו אלימים ושכל בוקר אנחנו רק הולכים מכות? זאת שאלה שאין לי עליה תשובה. אני חושבת שזה לא הוגן, אני חושבת שמציירים אותנו ממקום של חוסר היכרות. אבל אנחנו לגמרי חיים פה חיים רגילים, נורמטיביים, טובים, בורגניים, וזה דבר טוב.
הסיפור של
היישוב
זה יהיה
אלעד.
לא, חשוב.
This is the farm. You see the goats downstairs? This is the farm. The goats belongs.
So it's like, are people in this community becoming farmers again or what?
No, no. It's only one youth. It opened it 2 years ago.
But Palestinians across the hill say that youth, 28-year-old Eden Levy, is responsible for some of the most serious violence against their town. We went back to Karawat Bani Hassan to revisit Mohammed, still on the road to recovery, to try and piece together what happened the day he was shot. The BBC has analyzed more than 120 photos and videos and spoken with many Palestinians in the area that day. Just after 4 p.m., Israeli settlers appear on the outskirts of Karawat Bani Hassan. Settlers say the violence began earlier in the afternoon, when Palestinians confronted residents from a nearby settlement who were walking in the fields around the town of Karawat Bani Hassan. At 4:21, an Israeli army unit is visible at the scene. But they fail to intervene as settlers begin damaging cars and other property. Word spreads to the town, and Palestinian residents try to stop the settlers. As tensions rise, tear gas is used to disperse the Palestinians on the hill. The IDF told the BBC they had used riot dispersal measures and live fire. In this video, we hear the sound of fireworks, which the IDF said were directed at them by the Palestinians. The IDF also said one settler was hit by a stone and slightly injured. In the chaos, we spot a settler speaking with the soldiers. He's carrying a rifle. At one point, he raises and cocks it, aiming towards the Palestinians below. It's hard to make out his face. But using his clothes, rifle, and distinctive kippah, we can say that they are consistent with images of Eden Levy. As settlers continue to damage property, some local residents try a different route to the top of the hill. Mohammed is one of them.
فاحنا اضطريت اطلع من هنا على الشارع الثاني. يعني انا كنت طالع هيك بالضبط هيك.
In grainy footage, we can just make out two figures. They've broken away from the army and settlers and are moving towards Muhammad. It isn't possible to identify them, but one is clearly not in uniform. Muhammad gives us his account of the shooting.
أنا انصبت كنت هان هو كان في هذيك الشقة يعني في هذيك الجهة كان مكرمز قاعد على ركبته ومصوب البارودة فأنا كنت طالع هيك طقني على يدي اليسار لفيت بدي أبعد عنه طقني في الخصر أنا بعرف إنه هذا عيد لأنه من لوعي من لبسه من سلاحه وعنده وجه مربي شعراته يعني معروف أنا شفته لما طقني أنا شفته.
There is no visual evidence of the moment Muhammad was shot or who shot him. Eyewitnesses said they saw Eden Levy firing his rifle towards Palestinians that day. One man who says he was less than 2 meters from Muhammad told the BBC that he saw Eden shoot him. As night falls, settlers and the IDF leave the area. Palestinian residents assess the scale of the damage. During the course of the day, two other Palestinians were injured and taken to hospital for treatment. Another man, Ahmed Asi, is unaccounted for. He was found dead, 130 meters from where Muhammad was shot. There were no eyewitnesses. But x-rays of Ahmed Asi's body obtained by the BBC show that the bullet that killed him remained lodged in his chest. It was a 5.56 millimeter rifle round. And from the weapons identified in the available footage, expert analysts told us that it was most likely fired from rifles carried by Israeli soldiers and by Eden Levy.
احنا عايشين هان في حالة رعب مش خوف بس يعني بأي وقت يمكن يفتح الباب يفوت عليك على الباب مع سلاح ما حدا بيقدر يمنع وحتى الجيش نفسه بيحمي فيه ما احنا ما بنقدر نعمل شيء
السلطة الفلسطينية تحمي
ولا اي شخص ولا اي جهة مختصة بتقدر تحمينا في شيء في ارضنا نهائيا ما بنسوي
Eden accepts he was present in Karawat Beni Hassan on December 2nd and adds, The attack on Karawat Beni Hassan is one of a number of recent incidents where uniformed Israeli army soldiers are accused of failing to prevent settler-led violence.
The IDF is being accused by both sides that it doesn't do its job, but I'm telling you that they do the job and it's a very hard job and they're trying to fulfill the mission in the best way that they can.
Avi Mizrahi is a former head of the Israeli army in the West Bank.
Most of the settlers in the West Bank are Israeli citizens which pay taxes, do their military service, and are law keepers citizens, okay? They don't break the law. Whenever you put outposts illegally in the area, it brings tense with the Palestinians that are living in the same area. Now, the IDF is protecting, first of all, the Israelis. Yeah. This is his role. He supposed to allow a normal life in the entire West Bank, also for the Palestinians, and he's doing his best. But yes, I do admit that sometimes when you have the Palestinians in one side and the Israelis in one side, you can find out that it's not a mutual treatment to both sides.
أين عندك وين أنت؟ أيوم 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 شايفهم؟ أيوم أيوم هذول المستوطنين بيجوا علينا على الأراضي بطرونا من تحت أيوم قاعدين بخيلوا هين مسلحين
For the first time since they were forced to leave their home, Aisha and Nabil Shtaya are trying to return.
Assalamu alaikum, Haj.
Ahlan wa sahlan fik.
They're joined by a group of farmers who have also been unable to reach their lands and by Israeli peace activists.
אפשר לדבר? אפשר לדבר? אפשר לדבר?
לא, לא יצא לי אותי.
זה משה שרביט. זה הסטלר שרזידס פה, בפוסט. הוא מנסה לקונפיסקט את כל האדמה
הזאת. זו אדמה פלסטינים פארמרים אומרים שהם אוהבים. and have been cultivating for decades. In the 1990s, the Oslo Peace Accord set in motion plans for a future Palestinian state. It divided the West Bank into three areas. In Area A, the newly formed Palestinian Authority, or PA, would run civilian and security matters. In Area B, the PA would run civilian matters only. And in Area C, all security, planning and building would be controlled by Israel. Palestinians living here require Israeli approval for any construction. They almost never receive it, making homes like Aisha and Nabil's illegal under Israeli law and subject to demolition.
هاي الأرض هاي اللي هاض هين هنا 10 دولمات هناك 20 دولم واحوال الدار 10 دولمات هاي هذاك البيت تبعي هاي الارض كل سنه بنحرثها كمح يعني هذا مرزقنا من 53 اشترينا ابوي وزيادي وعمامي من الحكومه الاردنيه يشتروها شو بتعمل شو بتساوي في البيت خالع باب البيت هذا المي بك نشرب منه دعس من هنا طبش الحنفيه تعشوف فين الطاقة الشمسية شو شو سو فيها تعال
مين عمل هيك
موسى واللي معاه
الله ينتقم منه الله ينتقم منه شو سويت فيه والله ما أهديته والله ما طبيت فيه شو سويت فيه تنسوينيات يلا تزر خاطره كله فجره
مين عمل هيك
موسى موسى طروني تحت سلاح حط سلاح في راسي
السكين يفسر القنابيات شوف القنابيات شوف
الدار شو عملت فيه؟ شو عملت انا يعمل هيت هيت يعمل هذا هيت هذا يعمل وشكفه في الخوصه السكينه شو عملت فيه انا؟ بيتي داري بيتي داري صرفت صورتي تنزها عمرته انا رممت ورا حمايبك كان 50 سنه لنا هون 50 سنه 50 سنه 50 سنه
It's not long before the Israeli army and police arrive at the scene. They tell the Israeli peace activists and the Palestinian farmers to take their equipment and leave the area.
المطلوب مني ان اقيم الكونتينر هذا بدي ارحله ما يلي ضل شغل هون على راي الجيش الاسرائيلي ممنوع ما في شو نسوي لا حول ولا قوه الا بالله يلا
يا ابو ساهر ابو ساهر خلاص دشرك منه مفروغ منه هذا الحكي
شوف البيت خرابة خرابة
شكرا كثير
While Britain has imposed sanctions on four Israeli settlers accused of committing human rights abuses in the Palestinian territory, the occupied West Bank.
Only yesterday, we for the first time announced some sanctions against violent settlers who were carrying out criminal acts in the West Bank.
הוא פוגע בציבור שלם, ציבור של מתיישבים שהם שומרי חוק, שהבנים שלהם נלחמים ורבים מהם נופלים בקרב על חיסול החמאס. שוויוני, היית צריך לקחת מאות אלפי פלסטינים ולהפעיל להם את הסנקציות האלה.
احنا رايحين على حدود مدينة رام الله. خليك تشوف قديش تلاصق ما بين المستعمر اللي أنشأت حديثا وبين مدينة عريقة لها آلاف السنين زي رام الله.
Mu'ayyad Shaban is a minister in the Palestinian Authority and documents attacks by settlers. He shows us how close even established settlements have come to major Palestinian cities.
هاي المستوطنة هاي بسيقوت احنا انطلقنا من قلب رام الله خمس دقائق او سبع دقائق كنا هنا هاي باب المستعمرة
شايف
يوميا هناك اعتداءات الجيش كان يوضع لهم حد في السابق كانت الاعتداءات اخف لكن بعد السابع من اكتوبر زادت الاعتداءات بشكل واضح وعلني
نعم هناك حكومة إسرائيلية لكن في الضفة الغربية من يحكم الأمور كلها حكومة المستوطنين ومجلس المستوطنات
ما هو ردكم على الفلسطيني في الخط الأمامي مع المستوطنين؟ الذي يقول أن السلطة لا تحميه؟
لا تستطيع قوى الأمن الفلسطينية التي مهمتها الرئيسية والأساسية هي الدفاع عن الشعب الفلسطيني وحمايته لا تستطيع الوصول يتم قصفها يتم إطلاق النار عليها المواطن الفلسطيني يقوم بالاشتكاء أو بالاتصال بالارتباط المدني الفلسطيني الذي بدوره يقوم بالاتصال بالارتباط المدني الإسرائيلي أو ما تدعى الإدارة المدنية لكي على الأقل يوقفوا هذه الاعتداءات لكن في ظل هذه الحكومة قطعوا كل الاتصالات والجيش بتعليمات من هذه الحكومة أصبح شريك وأصبح حامي لهذه المجموعات وشريك حقيقي في الاعتداءات
The Israeli forces apply in the West Bank the policy of the government which exists at that time and rules Israel. I would say that this government right now is not trying by their actions to bring those flames down and the contrary, they are bringing them up. Because now the outposts or what we called back then illegal at that time outposts are being in the area with the authorization of the government, with the backup of the government. And that's different from the time that I was there.
Most of the sanctioned settlers live in outposts dotted across the occupied West Bank. And among them is Moshe Sharvit. He has been sanctioned by the US, EU, Australia and Japan for human rights violations against Palestinians, and by the UK, who say he forced 20 families from their home. Just weeks after the UK measures were announced, a local camera crew filmed an open day at his farm.
אנחנו ממש כאילו, תבינו, אנחנו חווה אחת קטנה, משפחה, עוד משפחה שהצטרפה לנו כמעט לפני שנה, כמה נערים, כל דבר...
Moshe talks to his visitors about the farm and the importance of it being in this area.
תופסים פה כמה אלפי דונמים, זה סדר גודל של עיר לא קטנה. אם מישהו מבין קצת למספרים של דונמים, 7,000 דונם זה אין סוף.
כל מה שנשאנו זה שלכם?
לא שלנו, זה של עם ישראל. הצרה הכי גדולה שקרתה לנו זה שבנינו יישובים, נתקענו בתוך הגדרות ולא יצאנו החוצה. בסוף המרחב זה הדבר הכי חשוב פה, בסוף החווה הזאת היא חשובה מאוד. אבל מה שהכי חשוב לנו זה השטח סביבנו. החווה היום תופסת סביב ה-7,000 דונם. שטחים פתוחים שבהם אף אחד לא נכנס, אף אחד לא מתקרב. מתוך הבנה שהגיעו לפה אנשים שמבינים שזאת הארץ שלהם והם לא...
Speaking candidly, Moshe lays out the strategy behind his outpost and how he's able to control 7 square kilometers of land, which Palestinians say is theirs. Herding outposts like Moshe's are just one part of the bigger settler network that receive support from powerful groups with strong ties to the Israeli state. They don't publicly state how they support outposts, but we've uncovered how two organizations are providing money and land that are used for outposts which are illegal under Israeli law. The first is Amana, an organization that has built and supported urban settlements in the West Bank and housing projects in Israel since 1978.
עשרות רבות של יישובים וכמעט 500,000 תושבים יחד נתקדם לעבר החזון הבא ליישב מיליון ביהודה ושומרון.
The real construction, providing services, providing infrastructure, bringing the mobile homes to the place. This is what Amana does.
In a leaked recording from a meeting with Amana's leadership in 2021, the organization's head spells out how much land has been occupied through building urban settlements.
הגענו ל-100 קילומטר מרובע אחרי 50, קצת למעלה מ-50 שנה.
But he says there's a new strategy.
בשלוש שנים, פעולה אחת שהרחבנו אותה במהלך השנים, זו פעולת חוות הרועים.
And these herding outposts appear to be more effective at seizing large areas of land.
היום שטח של קרוב לפי שתיים משטח יישובים הבנויים.
These court documents show that Amana loaned hundreds of thousands of shekels to help establish some outposts that are illegal under Israeli law. In one case, they loaned more than $1 million, or $250,000, to a settler for buildings and livestock. And once he'd established an outpost, he received more than $1 million from Amana to help connect it to electricity and water. Just outside of Jerusalem, we see how herding outposts can be just a first stage in the creation of much larger settlements.
זהו, פה קורה כל החתונות בעצם, זה הגן אירועים.
Ariel Greenglick's farm was established as an illegal outpost in 2019, with the support of Amana.
פה אנחנו גרים, זה הבית שלנו, זה אשתי שמה והילדים. אנחנו עלינו לפה לפני 4 שנים, והכל באנו בעצם להקים פה חווה במטרה לשמור פה על האדמות.
But in 2023, the Israeli government started the process to legalize this outpost, paving the way for a huge urban settlement to be built, with over 3,600 homes.
זה לא האדמה שלי. כשהגעתי, ידעתי שאני פה בצורה זמנית עד שיקימו פה משהו. מראש גם לא התחברתי פה לדברים שאני עושה, ידעתי שאני פשוט עושה פה איזה תהליך שבסוף ייגמר.
Nine other outposts began the legalization process in 2023, whilst at least six were granted full legal status by Israel, showing how herding outposts can become the settler cities of tomorrow.
هذه المستوطنات او هذه البؤر لا يمكن ان تحيا لحياه، لابد ان هناك حركات حقيقيه وجمعيات تقوم برعايتها وتمويلها، هذه الجمعيات معروفه لدينا، لدينا الكثير الكثير من الجمعيات التي فعلا بالتوثيق تثبت تورطها في دعم هؤلاء المستوطنين.
A second key body supporting settlers is a World Zionist Organization or WZO. It's been around for more than a century. And was instrumental in the establishment of the State of Israel in 1948. One of its key departments is the Settlement Division, which describes itself as an arm of the Israeli state.
It's a body which runs very, very, very big part of a land which had been expropriated by the Israeli authorities in the West Bank to different Israeli settlements or settlers.
The Settlement Division doesn't publish details about its individual dealings with settlers. But contracts obtained by the settlement watchdog Peace Now help us understand more. They show how the Settlement Division allocates large areas of land for grazing and farming throughout the West Bank. But the contracts forbid the building of any structures. One of them is for an area we know well, Hamra.
What you see here, you can see this is the contract between the WZO, yeah, and a settler which will hide his name. And you can see this is the area which was allocated to him, the red stains on the map, yeah. This is here, this is where we are right now. There's only one settler here in the area where the herd. This is Moshe Shalvit.
The name in the document is redacted. We can't be sure if it's Moshe Sharvit's contract, but the date matches when he arrived in the area. We have also found evidence of the WZO allocating land to other settlers who have set up illegal outposts. Eden Levy is one. When we contacted Eden Levy, his lawyers told the BBC that his farming outpost had been allocated to him by the official authorities. And he had a contract he signed with the Settlement Division. On another contract we've seen, a settler's name is clearly visible, Zvi Bar Yosef. He is also sanctioned by the UK and the US for using intimidation and violence against local Palestinians. Like Moshe Sharvit and Eden Levy, he lives in an illegally built outpost. And we found at least three other outposts on land allocated by the WZO.
There is a massive Israeli state involvement in this outpost, but this entire involvement is done in counter to the law, in counter to the law that the same state is supposed to apply.
Since October the 7th, more than 30,000 Palestinians have been killed and 70,457 injured in Israel's military offensive on Gaza.
Months into Israel's war on Gaza, and settlers are hoping to expand their movement.
We're going to stay in Gaza. It's our country and this land is ours. Nobody can take my land, okay?
And you want to go into Gaza right now?
Yes. We must establish Jewish settlements in Gaza Strip. We have to delete the term Gaza Strip. If we don't do that, all the whole war was in vain.
Today's demonstration is in memory of Moshe Sharvit's brother, Harel, who was killed fighting in Gaza.
הראל, הוא היה אצלי יומיים לפני שנפל, ואומר, אני לא אכפת לי למות כדי שעם ישראל ימשיך וינצח.
It's to not forget him and to say, we have to get back to there. This is our country.
A group of settlers managed to break past a soldier standing at the border and erect two small structures before they were taken down by the army.
They said, we're here in the Gaza Strip and we are starting our first town here in Gaza. It's just saying that this is where we want, this is where our heart is, and this is what the next step is.
The act was largely symbolic, but it was the first time these settlers had set foot in Gaza in almost 20 years.
Well, the UK has announced new sanctions against some Israeli settlers for attacks in the occupied West Bank. It's the second such round of sanctions imposed since February, and it follows similar moves by the EU and the United States.
Four more settlers are sanctioned by the UK government, and this time Eden Levy is among them. They say he took part in assaults and intimidation of Palestinians as part of a wider campaign to drive them out of the area.
הכפרים. אנחנו בעצם מתמודדים כל הזמן מול הערבים, מול השתלטות הערבית על שטחי C ביהודה ושומרון. בעצם מונים את ההשתלטות שלהם כדי שלא תוקם פה מדינה פלסטינית ונוכל ליישב את כל ארץ הקודש.
تلقيت خيار فكوس الله بنعمل مخلل
ودي هن هناك فوق عند ابوي
ليتي كنت احمل فيها كثير شغلات اليوم فيش قليل جدا وين عم لساتنا بنعمل جلسات طبيعيه تقولوا لي في حد انه وصلنا انه خلص فيش امل من جلسات طبيعيه راح نعمل كمان عمليه لحد الآن ولا في أي محكمة نصفتنا في هذا الإشي فيش إشي قوة تقدر توقفها عن الإجرام اللي بيعملوا فيه قالوا إنه راح يأخذ عقوبات بس هل العقوبات طبقن عليه فعلياً؟ ما حدش بعرف شبنا واحد أحسن من أرضياته وزريعته وشغله ودورهم على البساطة عايشين الحمد لله يطلعوا من هنا وما بدنا أكثر منه
المطلوب فعلا عقوبات حقيقية ضد دولة الاحتلال لأنه لا يمكن لهذا المستوطن أن يتمخطر ويذهب ويأتي في الضفة الغربية ويحمل سلاحه لولا أن هناك دولة تحمي هذا وجيش يحمي هذا المستوطن
After repeated attempts to speak with Moshe Sharvit, we decided to visit his outpost to question him directly.
I think there is a gate.
Yeah, there's a gate, that's as far as we're going to get.
Okay, Tov.
Okay, Tov, Moshe. Moshe, we're from BBC, and we're going to ask you some questions.
We want to speak with you about the sanctions.
I don't want to talk to you.
But I'm Israeli, I don't want to talk to you.
We find him alongside his brother, David.
We've spoken to a lot of the Palestinian families here who say that you've used violence on them, forced them out of their homes. What do you have to say? It was definitely you, we filmed you. We've spoken to a Palestinian woman who says you put a gun to her head. No, it was you, Moshe Sharvit, who sanctioned internationally. So will you let the Palestinian families return to this area?
Those people in those outposts, they don't fear for their life. They know that they can defend themselves. They take in account that they can be harmed. But they still do it because their ideology is that it's our land, we should be there, and I don't care about what the Israel government is saying.
Hi, Mohammed. You're not coming?
I'm coming.
Okay. Because there are already two people here from Moshe.
More than 5 months since they were forced to leave their home, Aisha and Nabil tried to return once more. Today, Moshe's brother David arrives to meet them.
بدي اطلع على البيت اذا سمحت بحكي عبري بحكي عربي هون صور هون صور هون
صبري يا مرار صبري
نحن لا الخير
بدي اروح على البيت مش بدك تطخ طخ انا بحب الموت
Do you speak English?
I speak English.
Huh? Why are you guys stopping all these people?
شربيت نتن له باوزن ما قال لك He's telling the soldiers what to do, you see?
بوني لخشان
I don't know how to scold him. This it's not a soldier for me.
اني كان
اطلع على البيت. انا وياك في السيارة. في السيارة بطلع معك.
אני אביא אותו, אני אביא אותו.
הוא בא לקחת אותה.
אתה תמת,
נכון. אבטי, שמדרו עבד. אבטי, שמדרו עבד. אני ויהו, שמדרו. רוח, אנתי, רוח. יש חרם עליך? יש חרם עליך, אני אביא בו לאחים. אנתי, בתחיל באמק, יאוכד וחד הוואחיה.